buildings and we need a community board. So we have around 270,000 square meter built space. And I've visited other NITs. I think we have the best infrastructure, one of the best infrastructures. Currently, we have 6,400 plus students, 22% are girls. And like high ranking KE students, this year we have 25 of the top 1,000 KE rankers, which is like very good, extremely good. And we have a flexible curriculum, first among NITs again. First to start MBA and MCA, sustained engagement with industry. We have all these and we run 9 BTEC programs now, 1 DR, 21 MTEC, 1 MR, 3 MSc, 1 MCA, 1 MBA, MS by research. So we have around 3,600 undergraduate students, 1,747 graduate students and around 1,000 PhD scholars, making it 6,400 students. Yeah. So we are supposed to have close to 500 faculty members. We can, because as per government norms, we are supposed to maintain a faculty student ratio of 1:12. But the sanctions came is 393, and we were running at, when I joined, we were running at 210. So there was some problems in recruitment. Luckily we could sort it out, and then we went for recruitment. We recruited 48, and now we are advertising for the next phase. We had the convocation 14 on 28th July, and we graduated 1,689 this year, which is the largest, highest number. Including this BTEC, MTEC, 88 PhD, and we gave the Distinguished Alumni Awards. This is the oldest graduate, 59-year-old person from electrical, receiving a PhD degree, and she is the VRT from metallurgy, receiving the President's Gold Medal. Notable achievements, some of which you may know, in TechEd, we got the best Project Governance in TechEd 1 and 2, Best Industry Linked Institute CII Award in 2015, Best in Social Responsibility, 2 awards we have, FICCI Excellence in Employability. We got the FICCI University of the Year in last year. I received the award on behalf of the Institute. Recently we won 2 very important awards, Best Innovation Club Award from President of India. Now this is President of India context, what is called a Festival of Innovation and Entrepreneurship in Rashtrapati Bhavan every year, where all the centrally funded institutions can participate. So we participated, we were shortlisted in the final 10, and remember, this is all the IITs, IASC and all other NITs and central universities participating. So we were shortlisted as the top 10, and we presented and we won the award. Recently we won the Green Campus Award, that's the student president Daksh receiving the award from the President of India. And recently we won the Green Campus Award from the Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board for all the green initiatives. And all this put together, we are maintaining our top position among NITs 3 years in a row, 16, 17, 18. We are 11th in engineering, I show it table a little later, and 31st in the overall category. The latest news is, we are setting up it's the inauguration is maybe this month. Center of Excellence in Manufacturing, it's the first of its kind, in collaboration with Siemens. It's a 190 crore investment project, 90% from Siemens. We put in only 20 crores. So it has 10 state-of-the-art labs. It will be basically for research and training, and as well as to train the industry around, and tier 2 and tier 3 institutes. this is the, you know, everybody is looking at this, including the ministry people, as to what are we going to do with this senior center. So it's a, I'm sure we will be able to serve the industry around and the students, and we will do, I'm sure we will do a good job. We have already formed teams, and I hope it will be a profit center. And these are the some of the projects which won us the Innovation Club Award. And of course, we have the 24/7 IoT and science labs. Recently, we hosted the Smart India Hardware Hackathon. This is a competition by the Government of India. We were one of the 10 institutes chosen across India to host it. It's a 24/7, 5 days competition. So it was really very interesting to host it. And the only problem is our students did not participate. So I hope next year we will be able to participate as well. Then moving on, after I joined, we formed a strategy planning group and we did a lot of exercises. So this is, I don't know, I know you can't read it, but I just want to tell you that we did a very detailed SWOT analysis as to how to move forward with the institution. So this is what from the strategy planning group, this is what we have coined: locally relevant, globally competitive. That's our new tagline. And we did a series of workshops and brainstorming and outbound workshops, etc. So our aim is to be in the world ranking in the top 500 in the next 5 years. And in NIRF, we are now 31. We want to, NIRF is the National Institutional Ranking Framework, that's the India rankings, which the Government of India started. We want to be in top 20. And in the next, in the rapid growth period, in another 5 years, we want to be in the US top 250 and NIRF 15. And maybe in another 5 years, we want to be in the top 100. Now, this is very ambitious, I know. So we want to move to interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary research and accelerated research, for habit of innovation, culture of entrepreneurship, and synergy through collaborations with industry, peer institutions, and we have to internationalize. Now, can we do it? So our answer is yes, we can do, because we have the best students coming in. I mean, I must say they are comparable to any vintage IIT student, because just by messing up one question, they must have ended up in NIT Trichy, but they are goes down by 1,000, and I'm glad you ended up in So we have very capable students, and we have very competent faculty. And let me tell you, in the QS rankings this year in Asia, the number of research papers per faculty and the citations per faculty, we are the second in India, next to IIC Bangalore. We are ahead of other IITs, so I am thankful to my faculty. They are very few in number, but those who are there are good. So all this, we are hoping that, you know, in a few years we are in the top 10. And I tell you, it's very difficult to break into top 10, because we are competing with IITs and other, you know, very strong universities. And when it comes to funding, the joke is, whatever allotment for higher education, half of that goes to IISc, the rest 50%, half of it goes to IITs, and then the rest 25%, something comes to NIT. So funding, they have faculty ratio 1 is to 10, they get all the research projects, but when it comes to comparison, we are all compared at the same scale. So it's very tough for us to break in, but I'm sure with all your help, we'll be able to move forward. So, and another exciting exciting thing is in the QS world ranking, our mechanical and production engineering is in 361 to 400 in the world ranking. So this is awesome. We want to move to horizontal centers where research laboratories will change into centers of dynamic excellence. Siemens is one example. Six departments are collaborating to work on the Siemens center. So from now on, we are including only interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary proposals. And we need to move into that new mindset of profit centers, because I want to tell you there is a major shift in the government funding. Because till now we were 100% funded, but from this year onwards, for any infrastructure, that is for building and equipment, it is a loan which we have to repay. So we have to get into that mode and think that before we invest, we will do a lot of analysis and invest in what will get us returns so that we can repay the money. So strategies to promote research, we recently signed some MOUs, and these MOUs are different in the sense that we wanted the faculty to go and spend time in the industry, that just signed grant MOUs. So publications, we are doing well, as I said, Web of Science and Scopus, we are doing well, 552 and 273 already in 2018. Sponsored projects, we got around 12.3 last year. This year, and this is very meager compared to IITs, but then we are working very hard to improve this. This is consultancy, this again we have to improve, but this I'm very happy when I joined in 16-17, we have filed only 2 patents. So we started an IPR cell, we made an IPR policy, and last year we filed 50 patents. And now we are already 6. We ran 8 GAN courses last year. This is with Tata Motors, we signed an MOU, and 3 teams of faculty went to their manufacturing plants and the research center and spent time this summer. And IEEE for you, we signed an MOU to bring to take engineering to the community. So we will be introducing an elective course in community ethics soon. SK Ramesh, you all know. Faculty already mentioned here, we recruited around 48 people. And this, we gave them a pedagogy training before the session started, and they are all with international exposure, very good people, because we didn't fill up the post just for the sake of filling. We took only excellent people, and I have already very good feedback from students about the faculty. We also recruited 10 administrative positions, and we are working on a paperless office. Hopefully soon we will move to that. Ignite is a teaching club where you know, the JEE students who come in, they started coaching other students from poor background, and then they launched a YouTube channel so that anybody can use it. So this is called Ignite. So this year in 2018, 20 students cracked the NEET exam, which is for medical entrance, and 2 crack the JEE exams by using those. And 4 out of 10 Kargil fellowships have come to NIT Trichy, 12 DAD, 6 MITACs and 1 SN host, and 33 deity scholars for PhD host them, which is a very large number for an institute. And this time they have started a new scheme called Prime Minister's Research Fellows, so we have 2 from that as well. Then Kalyan has become very big, and we got some excellent speakers this year. These are some of the speakers for Kalyan, and number of events are increasing. In fact, the Kalyan Sangam projects won us the Innovation Club of the Year award. Festival, again, very, very nice and growing, very healthy, and very intense competition. Mid-fest this year we had Dr. Vasudev Menon as the chief guest to inaugurate. Sports, we are doing very well. We are champions in many inter-NIT events, and this year we are hosting 3 inter-NIT events in the institute. Social responsibility, we got many awards, we are doing very, very well. And I must remember that Dragon was a big contributor to the social responsibility. We have an incubator called SETI, which incubated 10 companies till now. But this culture is a little, we have to grow that culture. It's not there in the campus. So I see Silicon Valley is the best place to request help to make this happen. Now we created a new office because it was not going beyond Trichy. Whatever we do is get published in the Trichy page of the newspapers, nothing beyond that. So we created this office. We have recruited people, we have a consultant, and we did a newsletter. I have a few copies here. So we have launched a newsletter. This will come out every month, and I think it should get circulated to all the alumni so that you can have a look at it. We created a brochure for the institute because there was nothing to read when somebody comes. So all this institute and memorabilia we are planning to launch soon, and our other branding is in progress. These are some of the alumni achievements in 1718. T.V. Narendran became the global CEO and MD of Tata Steel. She got the Distinguished Alumnus Award. Chief Science Advocate of the PM, that's a new post they have created. Mr. Alagesan became Chairman and MD of ITA Limited. Nambi Rajan, he got the IJP Alexander Graham Bell Award 2018, which is a very great a great honor. N.S. Kannan became MD and CEO of ICICI Prudential, and Kriti Vasan, 2016 Raj, is the IAS topper of Tamil Nadu 2018. He is the 29th All India rank and Tamil Nadu topper. He was, I think, Pranjan chair in 2016. Harpiya, 2017 batch, she got the Srambhajee Faculty of the Future Award, which is to encourage women to take up teaching in STEM. Vita, doing a wonderful job. So I gratefully acknowledge the efforts, request to increase the chapters across the world, and invite alumni to form new chapters and reactivate the existing chapters and contribute to the institute in many ways. This the labs which we were talking about, RC Middle School, scholarships, Root of Solar. Now this was happening, but then coming to the institute, I heard from many corners that institute is actually not supporting the alumni contribution, but there was nobody to take care of it. So we created this cell, Alumni Institute Interaction Cell, last year, a few months back. Recently we appointed a dean, institutional development and alumni relations. In the last board meeting, I got this approved. We have appointed Dr. Raman from Metallurgy as the dean alumni relations, and today morning, he must have reached Bangalore. He's traveling to Bangalore to take part in the ceremony of Mr. Rajan as the alumni dean of the institute. And we have an associate dean, Dr. Venkatutika, and we have appointed 2 staff members. We have inaugurated an office. So this is functional. And we have launched a website. We have created a website and launched it. alumni.nit.in. So there are committees. AIIC is to complement RECAL, because RECAL has to unite the alumni, but connection to the institute, the cell is going to be. Now to connect, these are the plans which we have to invite alumni to the campus, to make arrangements. gotten MBA, MIA awards, and many more. You know, chair positions, extracurricular lectures, and any other portfolio, because we have just started. We are just looking at other institutes, what they are doing. So I got a lot of inputs from New York meeting, Minneapolis meeting, here also I'm sure. We are looking at IIT Madras, we are bringing people from there. We had a one day brainstorming how to start with, etc., etc. For example, back to campus, one day or half day program, nostalgia campus, hostel assist, coffee with deans and director, meeting with your favorite faculty members, interaction with students, a lecture, etc., etc. We plan if you come to the campus. This is the 93 batch. When I came in the morning, and I saw a procession with drums and everything, so I was about to call on the security officer and, you know, give him a file. What is happening? Why did he let all these people in? Then I saw the uniform, then I said, okay. This is their group photo in front of the institute. So we need your time to mentor, motivation lectures, participation in academies, bodies, etc. We need your talent, internship, project opportunities, mentorship, training, spend a few weeks in the campus, and we need your, this is the website, part of the website, if there's internet, I can show you. So we have voluntary mentorship programs, you can click on it, go to the website, give your details, and somebody from there will contact you, how we can use you. And obviously we need your pressure in the end. So creating laboratory facilities, research facilities, travel plans, green drive on a big green drive in the campus. We already planted around 5,000 trees. We are going to plant another 20,000. The first year students will come in 1,700. We are going to ask them to plant 5 trees and look after them for 4 years. The website is on, so you can mentoring, these are the, you go and check out this. So here from the alumni, I was just thinking today, and this slide I just put it across, visit this website and the institute, come down to the institute. We have started in a humble way, we have a long way to go, but I'm sure with all your support we will move forward. And this time I'm putting this across because we need to improve our ranking. Our ranking doesn't reflect what we are. And I know the reason, we did extensive analysis of the ranking parameters, so I know exactly what can be done. I'll show you in the next slide. So need help in strengthening MOUs and exchange program, because there's a lot of emphasis on student and faculty exchange. One semester exchange. We started something with, so under this Dean Alumni Relations, we have another Office of International Relations will come under this Dean, where we will be encouraging students to apply. We will facilitate the exchange program, and with flexible curriculum, it's possible for them to spare a semester. We want students from abroad to come, maybe from not from the same country. If I ask US students to come to Trichy, they may not, but then I can get students from Sri Lanka, Malaysia, or you know other countries to come, but we can send our students to higher ranking institutions. So that has to be worked out. But it carries a lot of weightage in ranking, and obviously the campus will become international campus if we do that. And we need faculty. You are most welcome to come and spend a few days in the campus, teach there for some time, and rest you can do video conferencing or another faculty can share. Faculty and students come and teach a course at night. In fact, I think Bhubaneswar is doing this very well. faculty from abroad coming and staying for a semester at Indian salary. We can pay Indian salary very easily.
Very close in the overall score, but where we are lacking is
teaching learning, this is teaching learning resources, number of teachers, number of the amount we spend on each student, etc. etc. So we are not scoring well there. Look at IIT Madras, 93.90. But I think this will improve now because we are recruiting and giving. And research and professional practice, again, we are a little low here because we put all the temporary faculty in the number of faculty, so the overall research output per faculty reduces. But graduation outcome, we are good. Outreach and inclusivity, we are good. Perception in India, we are good. But IIT Madras, it's 100%. So we need to improve here. We need to improve here. We need to improve here. So, you know, this is how the ranking works. So, I'm sure we can do this. This I already mentioned. And finally, before I conclude, send your questions. Incredible campus, locally relevant, global.